Banned in Britain, my new book. And it's up only on michaelsavage.com. It's banned on Publishers Row in New York. They would not touch the book. Now, remember, I'm a man who's written 4 New York Times bestsellers. Think about that. They should be clamoring for my book. They wouldn't touch it. Not one New York publisher wanted the book. I don't care. They are the silent movies in an age of talkies. Talkies being talk radio. Talkies being the internet. Talkies being Facebook. Talkies being Twitter. I have a Facebook account that's going up on michaelsavage.com this week as well. Twitter account. And I am able to reach you without them. Thank you very much. You want to know what the First Amendment is? I am the First Amendment. I am the First Amendment. And I'm fighting on my own without one of the great New York lawyers to help me. I wouldn't touch them with a 10-foot pole, so to speak. All they want is your money. So they can go to their friends in the courts and see if they can get a little more money out of you. Hey, Milty, see if you can keep him on the list a little more. I can milk another 100 grand out of him for your daughter. We can fill. Don't get me started here. It's as corrupt as Bernie Madoff. The entire legal system is like when Jesus was crucified by the Sanhedrin. You want me to tell you that story about the Sanhedrin? The 14 judges? 5 of them said Jesus is not guilty. Don't crucify him. I guess they were the secret emails of the day. What are you crucifying the guy for? He didn't do anything. The other judges said, hang him. I'd rather crucify him because the Romans told us to do it. He's a threat to the order. This story's been told before. It goes around and around the story over and over again. So if you don't mind, I'm going to get my name off the list. If you don't mind, I'm fighting for me. And if I am not for me, who will be you? But if I'm only for me, I'd be a bore. That's all. So go to michaelsavage.com to see Banned in Britain. I'm very proud to offer it. And the phone number here is 1-800-449-8255. MichaelSavage.com. British swimming pools imposing Muslim dress codes. Did you hear about this one? It's up on MichaelSavage.com. Under the new rules of the spineless Labour government in England, swimmers, including non-Muslims, are barred from entering the pool in normal swimming attire. They have to wear full-body costumes. You hear this? I mean, Churchill is rolling over in his grave. Churchill is rolling over in his grave. These spineless left-wingers in England are making everybody wear full-body costumes. It's one thing to say, all right, reserve the pool during certain hours for Muslims. Even that would be offensive, frankly, to start with a division like that and prejudice like that. But, okay, but no. Now non-Muslims have to wear full-body coverings. Now, the truth of the matter is, you can argue whether or not bathing suits have become too skimpy, but that's not the issue. The issue is, what's going on in England is a result of cowardice. And the very same cowards who are caving into the radical Muslims and Sharia law have attacked me and put me on a list with murderers and terrorists. Remember, they didn't put me on a list with people banned for writing things and speaking. Oh, no. Modesto, California, Bernadette, thank you. You're on the air with Michael Savage and millions of others. Go ahead, please.
Hi, Dr. Savage. I wanted to tell you the reason why I tune in, and that is to hear the truth. I don't get the truth.
Let's put it to you this way. It's one man's truth. I don't claim to speak for the world, nor for every American. I speak for myself, and apparently it resonates with a lot of people.
I believe it.
In other words, I'm telling you what I think. It's as though you have a family relative who's very outspoken. People used to be like this in America before it was stolen from them by the illiberal left. Before the country was stolen by the illiberal left who said you can't say this, you can't say that, you can't think this, you can't think that. A boy used to chase a boy in a schoolyard and give him a punch in the nose. Now the kid goes and takes a bath. They put a helmet on him in a bathtub, raising a nation of sissies. What has happened to this country? Boys who stormed Normandy, now their grandsons are being given a helmet to go bathing in a bathtub. Can you imagine the nation you're living in? What this nation will be like in 20 years? Boys being taught to be afraid to take a bath by themselves? Boys put on dangerous psychoactive drugs in case they actually act like Tom Sawyer in order to suppress them, control them, compress them, and turn them into chickadees? I'll be right back.
Savage.
Oh, God. Okay, play Bob Dylan, any Bob Dylan. He was found disheveled last week walking around New Jersey. It's an interesting story because he behaved so nicely when the police didn't know who he was, as opposed to a certain professor from Harvard. Who's this? I can't hear it. Why is it so quiet? The harmonica got a lot of girls hysterical in that thing. And the shoulder was dark. went psycho, gave themselves away for nothing. Only for the guitar with the mouth. Guitar and the harmonica right away.
It is
patchouli oil, no shaving under the arms. The next thing you know, there's Obama in the White House.
Many years
I don't know how it connects, but it does, right? All the patchouli oil, hair under the arms, no brasiers, and the next thing you know, Obama's the president, the whole country was shafted by the left wing. How did this happen? They're all 60 years old with transfusion trees and walkers in Marin County. No anti-war protesters anymore. It was all during the Bush administration. No war for oil. Now that we're in Afghanistan, you don't even read about it. Not even there. You don't even see it in the paper. Where do you see anything about Afghanistan in the Associated Press? Nothing. It's all about the evil right wing at the town hall meetings. Nothing about Al-Qaeda being a threat. Nothing about Afghanistan. There is no war because it's Obama's war. So the government media complex tells you there is no war. And if there is, it's a good war. That's why there's no war protesters. But there will be. Mark my words, the military and the military families will be the war protesters. You wait and see who they will be. Mark it down. Mark it down. Again, go to michaelsavage.com. If you don't mind, please go to Michael and buy Band in Britain, because I'm only going to print one first edition, one first printing, and that's going to be it. And many of you bought Psychological Nudity, first edition, first printing. Then I told you I had to. First edition, second printing, blah, blah, blah. They will have value. They will have value right now when you read them. There's actually a letter of action that you can take in the back of the book. There are things we can do to stop this. I only wish that some of those in the media who understand what the First Amendment is would get behind me, but they won't. There's political jealousy. There's personal jealousy. Why should he be jealous just because I called him Pawn Vanity for so many months? Why? What is wrong with calling a man Pawn Vanity? I don't understand it, or the golfer. Or the leprechaun. Why should that make them mad? I don't get it. They call me names. I'm still going along. Whatever. I'm having fun. President Obama spoke to the VFW today and talked about his pledge to the armed services. It was disgraceful. The nerve of him to get up there and say that a woman who was a typist in the Eisenhower's office was on par with the men who stormed the beaches at Norway. I couldn't believe it. And then he talks about the men in the gutters. Like every vet who comes back is in the streets. That's such a left-wing legal lie. Flashbacks to loved ones. Play clip six so they know what I'm talking about.
The VFW well knows, for so many veterans, the war rages on. The flashbacks that won't go away, the loved ones who now seem like strangers,
classic,
the heavy darkness of depression that has led to too many of our troops taking their own lives.
Okay, let's stop right there. What percentage of our returning troops have taken their own lives? What percentage of our returning troops from Iraq and Afghanistan are depressed because of the war? Minuscule numbers. I don't say there aren't any, but this is pure left-wing propaganda from Obama, who is a lawyer, who represents the American Trial Lawyers Association, who represents MoveOn.Drek, who represents every left-wing crackpot organization in America. He doesn't represent the military. I don't know how the guy has the agates to go into the VFW. How this guy who hates the military his entire life, who built his whole career hating the military, how he has the agates to go into the VFW and tell him as their commander-in-chief, he won't put him in harm's way unless there's a reason. Did you hear that one? Listen to clip five. Listen to the agates on this guy.
That's why I made this pledge to our armed forces. I will only send you into harm's way when it is absolutely necessary.
Hold it. Let's stop right there. Can you imagine this? I, as commander-in-chief, will only send you in harm's way when it's absolutely necessary. This from a radical left-winger, off-the-charts left-winger, not liberal, all his life an anti-war guy, all his life a military hater, all his life a cop hater. Now he's commander-in-chief and he's telling him only send him in harm's way. A man who I guarantee you never shot a Daisy BB gun. I'll bet you as I stand there that Obama never shot a Daisy BB gun. He's now commander-in-chief. I don't know. It's like it's Alice in Wonderland. The whole thing's crazy. Who's the organ grinder? Who is the organ grinder behind this country? I'd like to know. Is it George Soros? I think it is. My guess is that it's George Soros is the organ grinder. And the rest of them are all on a string while he grinds away and puts the money into the machine. Last week, he gave away $125 million to the poor in New York. He makes that probably in 10 minutes in New York from currency trading with inside information, in my opinion. My guess. No reason to believe it's true. But I do know this. In 2008, the Soros Fund made $1 billion while virtually every other hedge fund lost money. How did he make $1 billion in the year 2008? How? I don't know how. I guess he's a genius. He has a crystal ball. Unlike Madoff, whose crystal balls ran out. You know what I mean? Madoff's crystal balls ran out. Oh, God, what a life. What a life. What a life. Why Afghanistan? Why are we in 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 Afghanistan? Why has Obama gotten away with a war that is almost as big as the troop levels right now are rising almost to the level of Iraq after the invasion? Why? Why are we in Afghanistan? Why are there no anti-war protests?
Savage.
He's difficult to describe.
He sounds like my dad with a PhD.
The Savage Nation. Talk 910 KNEW.